let's get right into it. So I'm going to be showing you guys how to do a flawless install for a quick weave, aka pronto weave. So I do add a shampoo and blow dry to my quick weaves. I enjoy this part because this way I have better control and I can gauge the health of the client's hair better, because it's very important that we're taking care of their hair underneath these protective styles. This way we're using the proper products and adding those nutrients that the hair needs at our expense and not at the client's expense. By any means, you know, do what's best for you, but this is what I enjoy and I see the best results with this. And I do offer a hydro steam for this service every single time they get a reinstall or I'm putting that quick weave back into their hair. I've noticed a major difference in my client's hair by adding this service. Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you're applying a heat protectant before you apply any type of heat into the hair after getting it wet. This seals the moisture and all those good nutrients that we put into the hair during the hydro steam. So we are going to be leaving out very minimal amount of hair. On the less heavier side, I leave out more on the edges because it has to cover. But even on the side that you're not really going to see the edges, on the heavier side, I still leave the edges out because we want to make sure we are not pulling edges out, ladies and gentlemen, okay? So then you want to make sure you seal the deal with some Purvana hair tonic. This is going to stimulate the hair follicles and moisturize it underneath before we put the solution on, the barrier solution. And then you want to get a stocking cap. I use both stocking caps. I like the stocking caps because it's see-through and I can really see where I'm putting the solution. So I didn't get the second part of this video that I like to do, but after I spray the Got To Be spray, I like to go around the edges with the barrier solution. I don't like using the barrier solution throughout the whole head because I feel like it dries the hair out more than the Got To Be spray, but that's just my personal opinion. By any means, like, if that's what you use and that's what you want to do, you know, do that. All right, so this is after we put that barrier down and we've cut the excess stocking cap off. You see that white stuff? That's just a solid barrier between the hair and the glue and the tracks. Okay, so now to the fun part. I'd love to start my quick weaves off with double tracking. This is when you are gluing two tracks at the same time. This was a great tip that I got from a fellow hairstylist. I'm able to get done with my quick weaves way faster doing this method. And this particular client, she loves to use four bundles of hair because she loves big hair. So this really seals the deal on making sure that we are thinning all of the hair in this install. So I have started to use single tracks at this point. My motto is better safe than sorry. So what I'll do is I used about two bundles of hair between the nape area and above the ears, and I was double tracking. And then I like to start to single track because I like to be better safe than sorry. So if I do have a decent amount of hair left over, I will go through and fill in where I need to fill in. But this way you ensure that you're not gonna run out of hair and you can really close your install out and make it very seamless. And you can see you naturally get done with the less heavier side before the heavier side. This just ensures that the heavier side is going to be exactly how you need it to be. It's going to be giving what it needs to give, okay? So as you close up, it's very simple. You just add your tracks. I do like to add a track right there on the part, just so when we do that leave out, it's just going to be seamless and you can't see a track. So for this last track, you don't want to use as much glue because this last track is going on the actual scalp. And we are in the business of healthy hair, okay? So we want to make sure that we're taking our time on this last track because we don't want the glue to get on hair for real, and we don't want it to slip and slide and go places that it's not supposed to. So take your time on this last track. So this last track, you want to make sure that you get it nice and dry and secure. You want to make sure that your blow dryer is on a medium heat setting and not super hot because you can burn the client's scalp. But yeah, make sure that it's nice and secure so that when you start to brush and comb, it doesn't move out of place. So when you are working with deep wave hair, you want to make sure that you mist the hair a little bit with some water before you start to blow dry or add any type of heat to it. This allows this hair to really blend with our natural texture way better. It makes it look real. This particular client, she does not like super silky perfect hair, so you want to take bigger sections and you want to have your iron on a a not so high heat. So if you do like that silky smooth look for textured hair like deep wave, you want to use smaller sections and with a higher heat setting. But she loves her hair to blend, her natural hair to blend with the extensions, and this is how we get that look. Guru tip, so when you get done curling, do not comb the curls out right away. You want to set them on the cool setting on your blow dryer and with the diffuser. I have linked the diffuser below. But what this does is it really sets the curl. That way the curl stays longer because we don't want our curls falling out. We want our girls to enjoy their curls. And voila, magic. Super cute, super full. This is, like I said, this is 4 bundles of deep wave hair. This blends naturally with a coarser hair texture. If she wants to, she can get this wet and wear it in its natural state, or she keep it straight. She will be back in 2 weeks where we will shampoo the leave out and shampoo the hair, but it is a special way that I do this service. If you guys want to see how I preserve the hair while washing it quickly without destroying it, be sure to hit me up. I'll definitely do a video for you guys for that. So there we have it, guys. All the tools, everything I use will be posted in the description box below with the link. This hair, same girl different hair, is owned by this client, a black woman. The diffuser I use is also owned by a black woman. The hair oil I use is owned by me, a black woman. So make sure you guys go out and support. Make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later.